So here with Steve Bell, CBE, for this episode of the Vote, leader of the Conservative group on Brighton and Hove City Council. Welcome back, Steve. We're going to have a bit of an overview, aren't we, of what's been gone on over the last kind of year or so. And we're going to start off with full council meetings and the wins you had in the budget, which seems a long time ago now, but it wasn't so far.
No, thanks very much for that, Mark. Yeah, we're in a municipal year, which I think a lot of people don't perhaps understand but realise that the actual year in the council goes from the 1st of April
yeah.
right the way through to the end of the March next year. So we're only quite new into this year of the administration. And at the budget, we did have an exceptionally good win there. We got 7.1 million. We got a lot through on our projects that we wanted to do, everything from improving the gateway of the city. So basically, our budget was based on tourism, the hospitality sector, and the people or the residents. That's what this was about. So it's to do up, make sure we money's into Madeira terraces again,
yep.
making sure we get some gateway signage, making sure we try and improve infrastructure coming into the city. And it's just generally tidying up, keeping things good, and trying to make the city look like it used to look sort of 12, 13 years ago, rather than, unfortunately, today, where when you drive in or walk in or bus in, all you see is graffiti, dirt and rubbish.
With those budget wins, I mean, Volks Railway, it was money for a new disabled carriage.
It is, because this is one of the other things which I find quite disappointing with the administration as we see it. Is the fact that they do talk a lot, as we know, and they're always out in the social media. But it's about delivery, and they don't deliver very much. And I can't believe that over these years they have not been prepared to invest in a disability access carriage for the Volks Railway. You know, we are a city which says we are diverse, we're for everyone, but they seem to exclude them. And we saw that when they closed off Madeira Drive earlier on in this year. The disabled people were not consulted. They had no access for their cars. They couldn't even get to the toilet. So I'm not going to say they forget them, but they get so involved with their own ideology that they forget what we're really here to do. And first and foremost, our role is to serve the people, the residents of Brighton and Hove in this city, and to make sure we provide their needs. That is our prime core reason for being a councillor.
Yeah. What else with the budget then? Because it was quite a heated discussion there, wasn't it, in terms of the budget. And we had a surplus as well, didn't we? £10 million surplus.
Well, okay. Do we know where that money's gone? We can talk about that. I mean, you know, this is just a typical scaremongering, which they constantly do, where they, first of all, they come out, it might be a £20 million shortfall. Then they said it could be a £30 million shortfall. And then they were saying it could even be a £50 million shortfall, blaming it all on the government, obviously. But in the end, it turns out we had no shortfall. We actually had a £10 million surplus. So a lot of the restrictions which they took away from frontline services could have been maintained. And, you know, people like Rise, for example, who they lost their contract because of the way that the contract was administered yeah. by the Green administration in Brighton and Hove. That's just disgusting. It's terrible. You know, these are people who generally need help. And that's what I was saying earlier. There's a theme here. They talk it, but they don't walk it. The most vulnerable people in this city are not being served by this Green administration.